You tricked me, Simon and Schuster. Hello, everyone. It is Jay from the future, just popping in real quick with a PSA for you all about Bookstagrammers.com. Bookstagrammers.com is a new online platform created for people in the bookish community and brands to collaborate on different projects or campaigns. So when I say people in the bookish community, I'm talking about Bookstagrammers, BookTube, BookTok, book bloggers, all that fun and good stuff. This is available to literally anybody around the world, so it is worldwide, and you don't need a minimum subscriber amount in order to register yourself. This online platform was created so that bookish creators are being paid what they deserve to be paid for the content that they are creating. The best part is that it is free to join and there's no mediation fees, which means that all of the commission or the money or whatever it is you earn is 100% yours. There's already 1,000 people registered in this program, so if you want to check it out and register yourself for some opportunities to join other bookish creators and companies, then I will leave the link down below and you can check out Bookstagrammers.com. I've personally already joined, obviously, since I'm talking about it, but I'm super excited to see what this new platform brings to my channel, so I definitely recommend you guys check it out. So go down to the link down below, Bookstagrammers.com. Hey guys, it's Jay, and today I am here with a little unboxing video. I have two packages. One is from Frenzy, the other is from Simon & Schuster. I believe one has three books of ARCs in it, and the other one is another Thriller Chronicles type of thing. So without further ado, let us get started. So I guess the first one we'll do is the Frenzy one. I am correct. There are three ARCs in this package, which Ashley from Frenzy emailed me about and was like, hey, I'm gonna send these your way. And I was like, all right, girl, hit me up. So the first one is one that was like the Booksplosion book of the month this month. By the time you see this, it's probably been a year since that happened, but it's To Best the Boys by Mary Webber. This is about a girl named Ren who lives in a society where women are raised to be wives and the men are the people who get to go off and have careers. She really wants to be a scientist with her father, so she decides to join a scholarship for all males. Every year for the past 54 years, all males of the eligible age are sent mysterious letters that basically invite them to compete for a scholarship. The poorer families are always looking on the list to see if their names are there, but the richer families are trying to figure out how their sons are going to survive. In the province of Caldon, there has been a deadly disease going around, so Ren and her father have been trying to find a cure. Then her mother ends up falling to the illness as well, so Ren decides, with the help of her cousin, that she is going to disguise herself as a boy in order to win this scholarship where she can go off and try to find the cure to save her mother. And basically this scholarship is going through a deadly maze called the Labyrinth, and not everybody survives, but if you do survive and you best the boys, you get the scholarship. Out of the three ARCs that I received, this one catches my eye the most, so I'm pretty excited to get to this one. The next one that Ashley sent me was We Were Beautiful, and it's by Heather Helper, and this follows a girl named Mia, whose sister and her were in a car crash where her sister ended up dying. Now she's very guilty, she doesn't remember what happened that night. Then she meets a girl named Fig. Yes, her name is Fig. Fig introduces her to her friend Cooper, and I'm going to guess that they're gonna fall in love. But basically, Cooper helps her remember that night, and then she, like, pieces everything together about the night Rachel died. I'm guessing contemporary book, you know, follows grief, redemption, all that jazz. I'm intrigued. I like the cover. It's like simple but like cute. The last ARC, I'm a little bit confused about the synopsis, but we here for it. We're gonna see what we think of it. But it is Between Before and After by Maureen Doyle McQueary. From what I understand from the back, there's a 14-year-old named Molly who's struggling with life. You know, she's 14. Life is hard at 14. And then her mother
gets depression.
She knows that her mother is hiding a big secret, but she doesn't know what it is. Her mother's a writer who is very good at diving into other people's stories and kind of ignoring what's going on in her own life, so Molly has to tiptoe around her feelings. The only person who is really able to pull her mother out of this depression is her Uncle Steven. Her Uncle Steven ends up being thrown into the limelight after curing a young man, so her mother is not able to hide behind him anymore, and that's when Molly finds a secret hidden deep down in her mother's dresser that might unlock a very big family secret that has been around since 1918. Apparently this is told in alternating timelines from 1918 New York City and 1955 San Jose, California. So apparently it's a historical fiction coming of age young adult story about complex bonds between mothers and daughters. I don't know, a little confusing, but I'm intrigued to see what it's all about. Okay, so the next package we got here is my Simon and Schuster package, which I'm pretty sure is another Thrillers Chronicles, which is basically their thriller books they send out wrapped in like newspaper articles, which like I think is super cool. So there were two newspaper articles in our little package today. The first one is "Breaking: Nuclear Weapon Detonates Over Washington. Tips for Surviving a Nuclear Attack." So we're gonna open this and see which book is inside of this. I don't want to rip it because I kind of want to read the newspaper article later. I actually requested an ARC of this and they said they couldn't send me a copy of it because there were too many requests of it. So they sent me it on NetGalley. Did not read it though, but it is The Last by Hannah Jameson, so I'm super excited that I actually have like a physical copy of it now because it sounds so good. So basically this is about a nuclear attack on the world and 20 survivors are left in this hotel, and it's basically them trying to like, you know, navigate around each other and that kind of shit. But I think it sounds really cool. I'm super excited, and it talks about him like losing his mind in this hotel, or if he should take chances in the outside world because, you know, it's now an apocalypse. So super excited about this. And then the next one says "Squatter in Storage Unit ?" So I honestly have no idea what this one is. I had a guess about the other one, but this one, 0% clue of what it could be. This is funny. This is another one that I requested and they said no, we can't send you that because too many people are requesting it. So you tricked me, Simon and Schuster. It's Social Misconduct by S.J. Maher. Basically, it's about this woman named Candace who starts a new job where she gets to like influence people online, and then she becomes the focus of a smear campaign, and she basically throws her phone into the river and starts hiding out in her sister's like storage unit. And basically it's supposed to be like a cautionary tale about like what happens on social media, that kind of thing. But I'm super excited about this because this is another one, like I said, I wanted to read and they were like, we'll send it to you on NetGalley, which they did, and I just never picked it up, so that's on me. But thank you so much, Simon and Schuster. I'm super excited about these two books because like I wanted to read them, so thank you. All right guys, so that was my not so quick unboxing, maybe quick unboxing, we'll see once I edit this what the time is, but felt like I was filming for a long time. Let me know down below if you guys have read any of these and what you thought of them, and I'll see you all in my next video. Goodbye!